Welcome back, wonderful moms. In our previous video, we have spoken about signs of adequacy of lactation. In this video, I'm going to talk you through how to boost your lactation. But before we do that, I would like to wish you all guys out there a very happy World Breastfeeding Week. So every year, the first week of August is celebrated as World Breastfeeding Week. WABA, the World Alliance for Breastfeeding Action, comes up with a theme every year. And it tries to motivate and encourage more and more mothers to go for the liquid gold. WABA this year has come up with a theme called Support Breastfeeding for a Healthier Planet. Do you know what this means? This means that mothers are the unsung heroes. They are the super moms without the capes and masks who are building an immune society to fight this COVID pandemic behind the screens. So three cheers to all those moms who are contributing to a healthier younger generation. Today I'm going to talk about foods that increase the supply of milk and how to let your brain know that there is a lot of demand for the liquid gold, and finally about letdown reflex. So what are the foods that increase the supply of milk? Oatmeal cereal, barley, brown rice, the golden standard ginger and garlic, fenugreek seeds soaked overnight, 1 teaspoon, that is around 15 to 20 grams per day should do the job. Nuts, especially almonds, and fish, that too specifically shark. Shark is a very good galactagogue. Then red meat, the mutton kaima, and greens, palak, spinach, moringa or the drumstick leaves. And certain herbs, thistle, milk thistle, blessed thistle, and goat's rue. There are certain herbs. I would say rather than using the herbs naturally, there are certain Ayurvedic preparations with asparagus and yeast and such kinds. Let us say galact. Galact is rich in asparagus and it's a very good galactagogue. Safe. So please discuss with your pediatrician and gynecologist and go for it. Rather than food, I would say water plays a very important role in the milk supply. At least a minimum of 5 liters of water per day is required by a feeding mom. And no extra water should be given to the baby. Apart from that, I would like to stress upon the fact that a pregnant mother needed only 300 extra calories per day, while a lactating mom requires 550 extra calories per day. So it is okay to eat short frequent meals throughout the day, especially the healthier ones like fruits and vegetables. That gives you a constant supply which doesn't wean off as the day progresses. Also, dehydration. If the body is dehydrated by the end of the day, the supply reduces by the end of the day. So stay hydrated and keep eating food in small frequent meals. What is this oxytocin reflex? Well, I would call it this way. The mammary gland is making all the milk that is required for the baby and storing the milk. It is waiting for an impulse or an order from the brain to, you know, now is the time when you should start the milk to flow down. So it's waiting for this impulse. And the brain has to release a hormone called oxytocin. Let us call him as Mr. Oxytocin. Mr. Oxytocin is a coward. Unfortunately, he doesn't thrive well in a discouraging environment. If we encourage him, yes, you can do it. If we give him confidence, then he completes this journey from the brain to the breast in a go. Let us say if the mother is feeding the child, but she is worried about the COVID pandemic in Italy, or she is worried about what happened in Wuhan or in America. Mr. Oxytocin from the brain has to go to Wuhan, Italy, America before reaching the breast, and he's lost somewhere in between. So the milk refuses to flow down very easily, and eventually the milk solidifies in the breast, giving fever and pain and the sensation of pins and needles to the mother. Mother believes that she is not making enough milk. So gradually she stops lactating. So the best way to go about this is to relax and to stay in the moment. Please do not worry about financial constraints, about your career, about your mother-in-law or anything else under the roof. Except for you and your baby, nothing else matters. So live in the moment, enjoy the motherhood, think about the baby. You know, even while you are at work, if you are trying to pump your milk, if you are trying to express and store the express breast milk, the thoughts of the baby and being relaxed play a very crucial role. I suggest mothers to watch the videos of their baby or to call their baby and talk, listen to those gurgling noises, those cries, those smiles, or to smell the clothes of the baby. I hope you found this video useful. Please like and subscribe. Thank you.